station, like a slow approaching hearse. I climbed aboard reluctantly, for better or for worse. Another day of tedium, lay ahead with no reprieve. And I sat in sleepy silence, with my mind on better things. She got on the train at Cricklewood, and she sat across from me. I woke up from my slumber, wondering was this still a dream. She had auburn hair that tumbled to her shoulders in a wave, and a smile so unwelcoming, she just took my breath away. As I fumbled in my pocket, so my glasses hit the floor. She cheerfully retrieved them, then we talked a little more. Her voice was sweet and gentle, with a soft Canadian lilt. Then she settled down to read her book, while I just stared and blinked. She got off the train at King's Cross, as I watched her smile and go. I sat there wishing somehow I had let my feelings show. But I never asked to see her, you don't do that, it's not done. It's the morning rush for work, and all you do is cut and run. Still I take the train each morning, on a good day it's not bad. You could fool yourself, you're dreaming, and not really going mad. And if you catch me smiling, I'll be thinking of the day she got on the train at Cricklewood, and just took my breath away. Hooray for Cricklewood, she took my breath away. Hooray for Cricklewood, she took my breath away.